Okay, so the first time we get into World War II is going to be in the African continent, Operation Torch. And we'll also talk about in this video General George S. Patton. Here we go.
We're gonna land in the second wave. As nervous and excited as I feel, I don't have a clue what awaits us. The code name for the invasion is Torch. The plan is to land 65,000 British American troops in the French colonies of Morocco and Algeria. The goal is to trap the Germans between the Anglo-American invasion armies and the British Eighth Army, which has been chasing the Germans across North Africa toward Tunisia. After undergoing 10 weeks of special training in England, Scheffel and the Americans under his command are now a part of a British provisional unit. It will be the ROTC grad's first commanding troops in battle. The night before we were to land, I go below deck and chat with my men. They're acting like excited kids. I tell them to focus and stay ready. Hours before Scheffel's convoy is due to land, German fighter planes attack. Completely helpless. I desperately want to get off this ship. It feels like a death trap. As dawn breaks, Scheffel's ship limps into port, listing at 20 degrees. Torch has been a total surprise. The Allies put 33,000 troops ashore near Algiers, including Charles Scheffel's unit. Everything is a disorganized mess. I have no map and no specific orders except to clear the dock and engage any opposition that we might encounter. I think the Brits just want us out of their hair. While Scheffel and the rest of the American forces are relegated to rear positions, British and American armored divisions push forward. Within weeks, they are only about 20 miles from Tunis, the Germans' chief port and main supply city. But before the British can launch a decisive attack on the city, German forces mount a furious assault, stopping the British in their tracks. Behind the lines, Charles Scheffel grows impatient with his British superiors.
I'm ready to get into action, but we keep getting all the crap jobs because the Brits don't seem to trust us much. I want to rejoin the American army. I am fed up, and after a heated exchange with my British brigadier, we're told to just take off. Well, goddamn, he won't have to say that twice. I round up my men, and we head out to find the ninth.
When he talks about the ninth, he's talking about the ninth Armored Division, which is controlled by this man up here, which is going to be General George S. Patton. Now, I could show you. I just want you to understand that George S. Patton, his nickname is Old Blood and Guts. Okay, he's a very profane, very outspoken gentleman, but he's definitely passionate about his position. Here's a clip from the movie Patton, which is a true story, just to explain the kind of guy he was. So to kind of set the scene up, Patton is visiting troops on the front lines, okay?
I guess I just can't take it, sir.
What did you say?
It's my nerves, sir. I just can't stand this yelling anymore.
Your nerves. Hell, you're just a goddamn coward. We have a yellow bastard sitting here crying in front of these brave men who've been wounded in battle. Shut up! Don't admit this yellow bastard. Nothing wrong with him. You won't have sons of bitches who are afraid to fight, stinking up this place of honor. You're going back to the front, my friend. You may get shot, you may get killed, but you're going up to the fighting. Either that or I'm going to stand you up in front of a firing squad. I'm going to shoot you myself, goddamn bastard. Get him out of here! Send him up to the front! You hear me? You goddamn coward!
Okay, so that's General George S. Patton. Some people would say he has a bad attitude.